What is up, y'all? Thought I'd bring it to a high on this nice, crisp 44 degree day. Yes, fall is here, just hoodie weather, so I'm good with that because I loves me a hoodie. This is a hoodie. In case y'all don't know what that is, I know quite a few people are not in the States that watch my videos. This is what we call a hoodie. Or a hooded sweatshirt if you're alive in the 80s and 90s. It's windy, it's cold. What's up, big guy? Good look at Mr. Snickers. Mr. Snickers, Captain Fancy Pants. Good morning, ladies. I'm back on my iPhone, guys, because my cameras are just sucking. So, Sprinkles, hi, I see you ripped your bin off the wall. Would you like to explain any of that? No, hi, Miss Brosie. Hi, Chai Chai. Now, China Cat has been letting me pet her, but I have the camera, so I don't know. Hi, baby. Miss Sprinkles, are you not in your bin where you're supposed to be? Yeah, I'll get her out. Hi, good morning. Good morning, goat. Good morning, goat face. You shouldn't be down here. She likes to jump from stall to stall to this bin. Hey, big boy. What's up, big guy? How you doing? You looking handsome, but you smell just like funk. Like nasty funk. Man, you are a beautiful buck. No doubt about that. These boys are ready to have some ladies. Your beautiful white hair on your face is all yellow and gross. Did you see him urinate on his face? Hi, boys. So that's what the boys will do. Now Jack's doing it right now. Make the face. So if I didn't put it in another video yet, these goobers, see his white on his side, how beautiful white that is? See this white on his head, how yellow and gross that is? Because that's all urine. Y'all stink. I don't want you touching me, fellas. The ladies enjoy that, me not so much. Look how wet and gross your face is. Y'all see how wet his beard is? Kind of hard to see how wet the top hair is, but you can see this. I know, Bubba, but I don't want you touching me. The ladies are coming.
Doesn't really matter. The boys are interested and the girls aren't. There's nothing happening in the next month anyway. So they're gonna have to deal. Just no lady love. Oh, this is what I wanted to show you guys.
Hi, sheep friends.
This lighting is terrible. So I've been working with little guy with treats and just patience and slow movements.
And now look. Good morning, buddy. Do you like the camera?
Do you see yourself in the Do you see yourself in the camera? Sorry. He's very interested in what's... Do you see that?
What are you doing, buddy?
Now, the bigger girls, they're doing a little better. They're more interested in whether or not I have snacks, but I have been able to get some neck pets in on them. Did you guys stay out in the rain yesterday?
Yeah, I know. Look at that face, little buddy. Oh, no, look at that face.
This is what I wanted, guys, because... When he's this size, she's about 150 pounds. He's maybe 50 pounds, maybe 75 pounds. I haven't weighed him in a while. But I want him to trust me and come to me and let me be able to move him from place to place. Because he's going to be joining the boys probably really soon, like today or tomorrow. Because when the weather gets cold, that's when the baby dolls want to breed.
Oh, I know you like the pets now, right? You're so adorable. You're so dirty.
I swear, baby dolls will find a mud puddle and go roll in it.
Okay, bye.
But yeah, he's gonna have to come outside soon because he's gonna want to start breeding the girls and I don't want February babies. It's just too cold. Oh, also.
We had a nice pumpkin grow.
I did not plant this. We were feeding the girls pumpkins last year and this just popped up. There's another one in there starting to grow. I didn't think it was gonna produce anything because the flowers would grow. And at a certain stage, about 2 to 3 days after the flower was open and looking nice, like it was gonna produce fruit, that's when the goats would eat it.
You can probably see they ate this flower, this flower, this flower.
They ate all those flowers off, so I thought they would just continue to do that. Well, it looks like two of them made it through, at least to turn into pumpkins. Oh, they ate a bunch of flowers off over here too. I apologize for the video, guys. freaking, I gotta get my camera situation figured out. GoPro 8 Black was super expensive. It's an awesome camera, but it's a piece of crap camera if I don't get more than 5 months out of it. I only dropped it once and it wasn't even very hard. So I thought, oh, I broke it. Well, turns out it's not me. The 8 GoPro Hero 6 Black apparently has an issue where it just stops recording. It just freezes. And I know if you guys have been watching me for a little bit, you've seen me struggle with it on a couple of my soap videos. But if you Google GoPro Hero 6 freeze up, and I followed all the steps to reset the camera, all the factory resettings, make sure all the firmware is up to date. Nothing, it just won't work. It'll record for 10, 15 seconds and then shut off. I'm cold. I think it's funny that 49 degrees in January. Well, that's today's temp is 49, feels like 44. In January, that'd be fantastic. It'd be like, woo, 49 degrees today. Why are you posturing?
This is hilarious. Hang on, let's see if I can catch you doing it. Come here, man. What are you doing? Snickety, what are you doing, buddy?
This guy still won't come to me.
What, man?
I know I say it every time, guys, but he's just, to me, he's gorgeous.
Do your thing, man. Show me what you're doing. Oh, yeah. Do the ladies like that? Is that like your thing? You roll that neck back and the ladies just come running? Oh, yeah, buddy.
That's funny, I've never seen him do that before. I don't know what that is.
You guys will see later in the season
when the girls are out. They're gonna start, I don't know how I wanna say it. YouTube won't let you put anything, well, I guess I'll let you put everything but breeding related, but the actual breeding without being demonetized. Whatever, it is what it is, it's their guidelines. The girls will pee when they're in heat and the boys will try to get it on their lip and they'll start flipping their top lip up and trying to smell it, which is hilarious every time. What's up, boys? Anyway, thought I'd continue on with my YouTube curse. So my YouTube curse is every time I say, I don't do this because, or I don't do that, or that's never happened to me, guess what happens? Yeah, that thing. So one of our viewers reached out and said earlier when I did a video, why don't I wash teats before milking? I do use Antibac on my hands. This is just a generic bottle that we refill, but I do use that. And like I told her, I get a lot of my information from the Ohio State University sheep team, but they cover goat stuff as well. And a lot of other goat forums that are out there. And I said to her, you would have to prove to me that anything and everything that goat does during the day is cleaner than what I'm doing right now. A lot of mastitis, and that's what we're talking about. That's what my YouTube curse is, the mastitis. A lot of mastitis comes about when you're milking, you're actually opening that teat hole, and that's the potential to enter bacteria into there. But I said, you know, you got to prove to me that that goat running outside all day, laying in the dirt, dragging their teats across things, dirty baby goat mouth from their kids nursing, is dirtier than my hands when I'm milking. We have never had mastitis in this herd, with the exception of Gypsy, because Gypsy's situation was different. She had a staph infection. When we bought her, she came with that staph infection. She was pregnant when we bought her. Right before giving birth, she got a giant pus-filled sac here. We took her to the vet, we drained it, we had it sampled, nothing. No results showed anything. But that was when we were at the other vet that we no longer use. She went through kidding, she cleared up, she was fine, she looked great, she looked like any other goat. She was shiny, healthy, happy. Went through breeding season, got bred, no problem, no issues. Right before she kidded again, she started developing some skin issues that was affecting her areas, you know, between her legs, like you would think your armpit or in the crotch of your legs, where she might have some moisture or some dirt buildup. She had some spots, some issues, some skin scaling, some big lesions, you know, like this occurring on her skin, bigger than a quarter. So we took her back to the vet. We did skin scrapings. She had a couple big sacks of pus developing near where her leg was rubbing close to her udder, so kind of on the udder at that time. So we collected some of that pus and the vet sent it in and had it analyzed. Well, it was a staph infection. That particular staph infection generally causes mastitis in goats. Had never caused mastitis in Gypsy, not once. She went through 2 kiddings, 2 milk cycles, and never got mastitis, but it only affected her skin. So she had some scabs, some hair loss, what looked like dry skin, or dandruff, if you will. So the staph infection for her that should have been causing mastitis presented on her actual skin surface and never in her udder system. Over the summer, we dried her off as soon as we could. As soon as the kids were weaned, we dried her off, started nursing her back to health. She started turning around. She was looking good. Her skin had cleared up almost completely. And then within a couple days, maybe a week top, she started losing hair again. Talked to the vet. They're like, yeah, it's the mastitis. We hit her with some pretty heavy antibiotics. It's called Draxin. We didn't realize that it was affecting the udder system because she was dried off. We weren't milking her. She didn't have any hard spots. It was just a skin issue to us and to the vet. Nobody had any idea. I came over here one day and she had a sore on her right side udder. It just looked like a surface. I don't know how to explain it. Same thing that was happening on the rest of her body, just some lesions, but it was on the udder, and it was about the size of a quarter, maybe a 50 cent piece. We kept an eye on it. We were hitting it with blue coat. We were hitting it with triple antibiotic ointment, and then she was on the Draxin, the antibiotics. Kept an eye on it. It looked like it was shrinking as we were treating her. And I came over here one day. I put her up on the stand. I was just giving her a physical check over, feeling udders. To me, that patch on her udder was clearing up. It was getting smaller and smaller. Probably about the size of a nickel. And I had her up on a stand, and what she did was she went to scratch an itch with her foot, and she kicked that spot on her udder. And the best way to describe it to you is that she pulled a plug out. I will show you a picture right here. I will put it up here in 5 seconds. You have a 5 second warning. Either fast forward or stop watching. She kicked that plug out and it just pulled out, and everything inside of her right side udder that I think was mastitis connected came out with that plug. Panic on our end. Called the vet immediately. Got her in immediately. Within 20 minutes I was leaving here to go to the vet. We did I'll have to double check the name when I get back to the house. They use as a drench to clean out wounds. That's what the vet recommended. Open it up, let it heal on its own, flush it with chlorhexin. So we were doing 60 cc syringe, just two or three of those a couple times a day, flushing that udder. All the gunk was coming out. It was cleaning up. The hole was closing up, and it closed up quickly. It went from like a quarter size to a pea size in one day, and to like the next day. I was struggling a little bit to get the tip of the syringe in there to actually flush with chlorhexin. So it was moving along great. That closed up, healed up. We stayed in constant contact with the vet. This is what's going on. They kind of talked to some of their people, and their conclusion was the staph infection is never going to go away. You're never going to get rid of it. We already had mentioned earlier in the year never breeding her again, because if the kidding process and activating her mammary glands to produce milk for the kids was setting off the staph infection, then we weren't going to put her through kidding again. After talking to the vet, she's like, you know what, it's a staph infection, it's never going to leave her body. Quarantine her from the other goats, try to treat her with antibiotics. The only way to get rid of the problem was to take her to OSU and have her entire udder system removed. So otherwise, let her heal up. Don't breed her. Keep her as a pet. After that problem, we got her udder cleaned up. We got her, it closed up. She was feeding over by the chickens, by the garden, food, water, shelter. I was going out every day and playing with her, petting her, keeping her company. But she just started going downhill really fast within a week or so of that. And we had to make the decision, which I've never done in my life, to put her down. So that's what happened with her. I've not made a video about it. I don't ever want to do like a clickbaity. I'm not gonna. Could I get 10,000 views if I put the picture of that udder up on as a thumbnail? Yeah, I guarantee you that would break the internet. I'm never gonna do that. I'm not gonna do that today. I'm gonna put the picture in the video and that's it. I say all that to let you know what happened with Gypsy first and foremost, but also to say that my goat, my favorite goat, my bestest goat, my best buddy Streusel has mastitis. Well, be nice. You don't have to be mean. I know you're the queen bee. Good morning, how are you? So we're dealing with that. Treatment is basically 5-day run of antibiotics and a 5-day run of cefepiron sodium, which you inject right into the teat opening. So I'm gonna show you guys that. If she's not cleared up by breeding season, we're not gonna breed her. That's for sure. I'm not gonna put her back into milk. Let me get through milking the rest. Hi, you're not supposed to be there. Sprinkles. In case your mama ever wonders why you obey the girls, are ornery, TBK. You picked the orneriest mama to take the orneriest goats. Let me get through milking the rest of the goat, and then I'll pop Streusel up on the stand and show you what I'm seeing and what we're doing.
Okay, y'all. So Miss Streusel, now she's always been lopsided. Don't think that's the issue. Her right side has always been bigger than her left side. Her left side right now is great. Nice and soft, no issues in there. This side, she still has a couple lumps up here, just small now. It was firm material inside there all the way down to here. And then it was starting to firm up right around the T area here, and more so right here, and she still has a couple little lumps there. I'm gonna call the vet today. We've done a round of antibiotics, and we have done a round of the, today, sulfapyrin sodium. I'm not sure if I'm saying that right. See right there where it says for lactating cows? This is what I say every time, guys. They don't make drugs for goats. Every occasional now and then you'll see for sheep and goat. That's your best bet. So since this is for a cow and this is supposed to be one entire tube for a cow, the goat forums, the medical advice pages, the vet pages say to give one of these per udder twice a day for 5 days. I've not seen anywhere that that was for a Nigerian dwarf goat, which is much smaller than a standard size, a Nubian, a La Macha, a boar goat, much smaller. We've been doing half a tube twice a day. So we're gonna keep doing that. It's cleared up. Like I said, she has a little lump here and a couple little lumps back here. And I've been massaging those every day before I milk her out. And she's not very happy about it. I know, baby, I know. But I've been massaging those, hoping that maybe it'll break up anything that's in there causing issues, help alleviate some of it. So we're doing that. And then what you need to do is milk out the udder as much as possible. She's pretty much shut off. She is shut off milking at this point. I'm not using any of her milk and soap. So I'm gonna drain her left side first. And she's already finished eating. Now I'm not milking her all the way out because we are drying her off. So there's no need for me to completely milk her out. Barely any milk coming out of this. But the directions say to get as much milk out as you can. I'm giving her a good massage. A lot of people say peppermint oil. I don't know what the peppermint oil does. Opens blood vessels, maybe. She's come a really, really, really long way. But I'm gonna get with the vet today, see if we should be doing any more. A little tiny tip on there. Should we make the camera focus on it? Anyway, tiny tip. That is going to go right in the udder hole. Of course, I missed. And then we injected a half a tube into the udder system. And that's definitely got her moving in the right direction. I'm not mixing this milk with any of the regular milk. Just set it off here. We've already gone through one round of this. I'm basically starting a second round, and I want to consult a vet before I do that. See what they think. Maybe some stronger antibiotics or maybe a stronger medication that I can inject into the udder. I mean, this is, I guess I don't know if it's the best just because it's everywhere. That's maybe mostly marketing, but this is the most readily available treatment. So that's what we're going with, and we'll go from there. And I'll keep you guys updated, find out what the vet says, and then we'll go from there. All right. Also, go click all the buttons. Like, subscribe, thumbs up, tell a friend, tell a neighbor, tell a stranger. Ooh, we hit 250 people, 250 subscribers. That is all. All right, I'm gonna let these goofballs out first. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. Hi, Rangy. He's so pretty. Anybody wants to buy a goat? Custard. Custard's the only one that's, when I tell you guys that she's tiny, this is 18 inches tall. She is within breed standards, but she is short enough. Wedge herself up under that milk stand. Hi, honey. What are you doing, silly? Kind of like a back scratch too, I guess. Tracy, you know how to pick the crazy ones. This is what you're getting next year. Do you hear it?
Oh.
Oh, this is, well, this will make for some good video. What do you think, boys? Maybe we'll get some cookie babies next year? There, he's peeing on his face, so you know, the ladies can smell it.
Oh, maybe if she sees me run.
Did you just spit cud? That is all. Goodbye.